What an interesting time we live in. For the past few weeks, we have been punishing people for shouting slogans. But from the last week, we have been punishing people for not shouting slogans. Waris Pathan, MLA of Maharashtra Assembly, who said that he was prepared to say Jai Hind but not Bharat Mata Ki Jai, was suspended with the MLAs of BJP, Shiv Sena, Congress, NCP, all voting to suspend him for the rest of the budget session for not shouting slogans. This was not demanded of by the assembly agenda, nor by the speaker. It was demanded of him by BJP Sena MLAs that he shout Bharat Mata Ki Jai. So now we have moved from punishing people for shouting slogans, which they may or may not have shouted, to punishing them for not shouting slogans. What is the next step? Isse aage kya ho sakta hai? The next step is pretty much that you can be punished for what you are thinking or what you are not thinking. There were such laws in apartheid in South Africa under which Steve Biko was arrested. He was thinking about committing crime against the state. Right? So that's your next step. Aage soch pe arrest ho sakta hai aapko. Aur ye karne wale kaun hai? Who are these people? The incredible patriots who are driving this process. One, these nationalists are people who always opposed the national anthem. In fact, they conducted a huge campaign of vilification against Rabindranath Tagore. So much so that Tagore, who was normally very, very, you know, gentle in responding to criticism, wrote several letters in anguish to his colleagues saying that they are lying, they are telling lies about me. In log ne kaha ye jo janagana mana hai, it was written, British sarkar ki prayers mein likha tha, emperor ki prayers mein likha tha, Tagore, and they always opposed the national anthem. These are the people who always opposed your national flag. Especially they don't like that little green part, you know, which takes about 33% of the flag, that they hate a lot. After the assassination of Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Patel in fact imposed that acceptance of the flag and the anthem as a condition for the legitimization of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. He insisted that that is a condition for the ban to be lifted on the RSS. So here are people opposed to your national anthem, you know which song they wanted, opposed to your national flag, opposed to the father of the nation, who by the way was assassinated in the same way that three rationalists have been assassinated in the last 2 years by young assassins wielding guns. So these are the ones who will lecture us on nationalism.